guys, it's Queen Deja, and in today's video, I will be reacting to movie 7 of the Garden of Sinners, BTW. Sorry that this didn't come out last Friday. I have been extremely busy from last week, even going on to this week. Hell, I might even be busy this whole damn month with everything that I have to do. And today is kind of really the only time that I'm able to film this film. And record the reaction or whatever. But just like always with some of these movies that I have to do, we cut it down into three parts. First part will end at the 50-minute mark for you guys, but for me, it'll be the 59-minute mark. Then after that, we will start at the 50-minute mark again, concluding at the 125 mark. Then continuing from 125 to concluding at the 2-hour mark. Once again, I will put in the comment below so you can link or sync my timer with yours. But other than that, let's go ahead and get started with part one in 3, 2, 1, go. There we go. That's better. Okay. Alrighty. It is time. The one movie that I really wanted to see, like, how this shit would conclude for her, but I don't know. Is that flowers? Oh, are you guys going on a date? Oh. Yeah, because she has the lock. Because she never locks her door. Are you going to meet that one dude? Okay, never mind. Or you could have just opened the door, Shiki. Like, damn. Oh, my God. Oh. You're pretty, though. Really? Oh, now you want it. Shiki, shiki, shiki. Good. Thanks, Cody. Oh, well, damn. See, I feel like, okay, so part one, like, was really good. I feel like this movie might be better, but maybe more gorier? I don't know. I mean, I don't know. I think I'm kind of, like, speculating that I kind of want to see more gore, even though we technically have, how many more movies we have? Because this is 8, 9, 10, I think it's 11 or 12 movies we have. Because I know initially, like, some people wanted me to just react to the first 8, but now there are people who are wanting me to now officially react to just the rest, including the movie that is supposed to kind of, like, be in... I don't know which one is supposed to be in between, because I don't remember the fucking name. Because I already downloaded it. Because I think it was the one... I think... Yeah. It was the one that took the longest time to fucking download, because it was so freaking huge, and it was the only file they had on Yon when I looked. But I don't know. Really, Cody? What's wrong? A grill? If you didn't buy it, who... That's girl code for if you don't hurry the fuck up, I'm leaving you. That one series I wanted to. This is what happens when you get extremely busy. Oh, damn. Oh. Seven Light and 13 Darkness. Kingdom Hearts. No, not really. Yeah, you do what you gotta do. You call him whatever you gotta call him. Damn, look at the bone. Oh. Jesus. It's like, Okay, what are we looking at? Ooh, more blood. Oh! So then maybe, like, okay, what the person, the murderer, did is, like, just cut one piece here, throw a little blood there, and then kill him right here? Maybe? It makes you wonder, like, since he is over here all the time, and I've never said this to any of them, why doesn't she just, like, you know, have a bedroom? Or they can just share the bedroom. Aww! I mean, damn, you only got no blanket or anything. It get cold. Oh. Damn, you don't even want to offer him water or anything? Why? I mean, it's possible. Hell, I've been sitting here thinking about it for a second or so, but I don't think it's her. It has to be the dude that was featured at the end of movie 6 leading into this, because of course, the Kide looking guy and Shiki are kind of destined to fight in it, and I'm guessing we're going to see that again in this. So then, where did the male Shiki go then? Yeah, it's almost like maybe she possibly feels, like, empty without it, and so she needs it just to, like, almost like she's craving something in a way. Ooh, damn. Why the fuck would they shatter wrists and ankles? I mean, it's almost like they truly want to torture them. She's not gonna be in there. Of course not. Dog, what the hell are you doing? Oh, okay. What's his face? All right. Oh! So then she also, no, not she. He had to be the reason. Fuck me. He had to be the reason of why she was sent to the hospital and it. Oh, okay. All right. Did we just do time travel bullshit now? Don't know. That could be a lie now. Come here. Come here. You little puppy. No. Looks so pretty. The reason why she was sent to the hospital. But then, okay, hold up. Now, see, the question is, why would she do that, though? Because of the fact that it's like, if Shiki herself, and I'm guessing Shiki, normal Shiki, didn't want to deal with this anymore. I get it. It's the only way that you can go. But, you know, of course, because she still truly loves Miki and she wants to be with him. But because of the fact is, male Shiki or murder Shiki wants to straight up kill him. Whoa, God. Is the crow? My thing is, why you walking out in the middle of the night by yourself? I mean, girl, you know, you just asking. Now, I wonder if he's possibly going to come back. Jesus! Oh, just because he cares so much about her, and just, you know, the suspicion too. I get that, but almost in a way, he sounds like a cute little needy boyfriend, and I love that. Oh. Well, yeah, well, you know, dead body. Oh. of course. I mean, where else are they going to get it from? Yeah, but what would Shiki want with LSD and marijuana? Now, unless there's, like, someone else out here, like, also wearing a kimono. Then, yeah, like, seriously. What is Shiki gonna want with LSD and marijuana? Because it doesn't seem like Shiki does drugs. That's gotta be the murderer. No, okay, no, that's Mickey. Poor baby. Are you a prostitute? Follow her. Okay, what about marijuana then? And no matter how far he goes, he's probably not going to find her that quickly. Okay.
course those two would be up there.
Well, you know, guys, it's okay. She gonna kill y'all, though. Like butter. So that was like what, four people? So then Cheeky has to be doing this. But Toko's not. Oh God. Interesting comparison. Oh my God. Ho, can you not? Just want to ask you questions. Yeah, because it seems like you know something about it. Yes, that's all. I mean, damn. That's classified. Well, I mean, because Shiki is the type of person who, you know, she's a girl, but she still almost looks like a guy at the same time, too. Oh, it's too late. I mean... And of course she was enjoying it. Well, yeah, because they know each other and maybe he can stop her. I don't know what the fuck he really gonna do, though. So just marijuana on a nutshell? Okay, do you still work for the boss? I mean, you have to be, but you probably have limitations. See, of course, can't be that easy to just straight up tell someone. Whoever it is, the face that he's making, oh my god, it could be anyone. Is it Toko? Is it Cheeky herself? Is it the Kide dude? Is it somebody we know who's gonna come back for like a second? I didn't take my socks off, too. There we go. That's better. Maybe. the fuck? Damn. Oh, yeah, that's the guy from the pre. What? Wait, what? No, hold on. That's the yeah. Miyoshiki? Yeah, that's what that is, I think. Bro, what the fuck is this? So how the fuck? Okay, hold up. So basically, you're now telling me that once she did what she did and he left, did he go in? I don't fucking know anymore. Oh my God. Oh. Nope.
We talking about Miki? Miki.
Hell, she might even kill you for that. Find Miki. Oh, okay. What the fuck? Okay, we got like a minute left before we go to part two. Damn. Somebody has an obsession. And of course it is nothing but Shiki. May, let me talk about it. Okay, all right. We ain't even gonna discuss this. Pause. I will see you in 1 second for part two. Okay, part two in 3, 2, 1, go. Maybe he's more like, not almost like a stalker, but also, he's also obsessed with her. There we go. So then they went to school and I got there. What, was he in the other movie though? Because I don't remember.
pictures, all those moments from part one. What the? So this dude. Mm-mm. But seeing Shiki makes you, like, sane and okay. Oh, shit. Why though? Like, I mean, you obsessed! Yeah, that was Shiki. But then why in a way are you continuing in her name? Uh-oh. Yeah, he got his arm fucked up. I mean, yeah, and how many murders have you committed? I feel like you've done a lot more than Shiki, probably. Just consume nothing but murderers and shit like that? And killing people? No, he ain't all right. I mean, I'm sorry. That's a dumb question to ask. You're in the way. Should not take him to the police. Yeah, you are. Alright, take that as a sign to don't find him again. Mm-mm. It ain't with finna get killed over for looking at his ass. Like, mm-mm.
Answer it. Yeah, I mean, she took my veil and complicated. Come on, damn it, Shiki! You can't go by yourself. Oh my god, once again, there is no I in team, honey. Trap them or something. I mean, it would be better for him to rot in jail for the rest of his life, to repent for what the sins that he committed, but killing him isn't going to bring those people back. You kill him, you know much, no better as a better than he is, or anyone else. That too. Shiki, you being hard-headed as fuck right now. Exactly. Yes, but you're better than that. You don't have to stoop to his level.
Yeah, but that doesn't mean you like it. Like, come on.
But you know he is. I mean, come on now. So you've grown so much. Why fuck that over now? See, you say that. Don't do this. Yeah, I think a lot of people believe in that. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And he's only like this because he did that shit. Well, shit, we fucked, aren't we? I mean, we really fucked with this one. I mean, seriously, all we can really do now is just kill him. Excuse me. Exactly. I mean, you know what? Let Shiki go ahead and kill him. That might solve all the problems. And then also, it's almost like when you kill someone, you can't go back to the same person that you were before. Now, if it's like in self-defense, you... As I was trying to say, like, with self-defense, it's really, it's different. You just missed him. Why? So you can just have him for yourself?
There's the marijuana.
See, you know, most people, when they probably get high, they just want to eat and sleep. Y'all be taking it a little too far.
Hell, I don't know. Drugs probably make you do, like, the craziest things.
It's just still crazy to think that someone like him, a character who was minorly in part one, to be a fucking killer, like, goddamn.
Shiki, you could have just did stabby stab. Stabby stab! Why'd you stop?
Of course.
I don't want to see this part again because this is gonna hurt, like, Jesus.
This is where she's gonna kill herself.
Oh, goddamn male Shiki.
to think of positive Blaven. Oh, so precious. But damn, you don't even want to say anything to her?
Well, damn!
Well, damn, finally you got here. Like, Jesus, what the fuck? Well, damn! I mean, Jesus Christ! I just froze. Pies, I will see you in 1 second for part 3. Okay, final part in 3, 2, 1, go. I mean, your girl won't fucking ask, how the fuck did this one person have so much saliva? And I'm like, hey! I mean, he was all like, all up in that, like, oh my God. Yeah, I mean, he got you good. The fuck? Oh, well, damn.
First you give me Yaoi, but you give me whatever the hell that was between him and Shiki. Then you give me Yaoi, and then damn.
He's not going to take it no matter how many times you give it to him.
Told you.
He'd rather die.
Yeah, like I said, do you think he fucking care about that shit?
That too. You gotta do what you gotta do. Yeah, and it's gonna be you. Oh God. He's here. Kill yourself. Yeah, but you know he wasn't going to do that anyway. I don't really think he did that. Come on now. That's Mickey we talking about. Don't make me cry over this, please. I don't want to cry. I've already cried like several times today. I know.
I mean, damn, both legs. And he died so fucking quickly, too.
Fine. Definitely gonna probably need some stitches, but he okay. Well, you know, Miki, it's kind of too late. Go ahead and, you know, I know, but she thought you were dead. Hell, I thought you was dead, even though I was like, surprising, he gonna be alive, but, it's gonna be so awkward. Aww. But you can still love her, even though she's done something so dark and twisted and evil. But she did it in defense, in a way, because, you know, we'll talk more about it towards the end of the movie. I mean, because we are almost done with this movie. I think we got, like, what, less than 15 minutes left? 14. What time is it? 9:44. That's gonna take him a hot minute to crawl over there. He ain't okay. Now he's almost there. You can be mad at her later. Yeah, he loved you, but yeah, it's okay. I'll have to do that weather one tomorrow. I would have liked to kiss, but you know what? Oh, it's okay. God damn, this was crazy. But I fucking liked it, and I liked it a lot. Oh my fucking God, this is good. Honestly, in a way, like, I never would have thought that someone like Leo, from movie one, who had a minor appearance in the whole movie, would be our major villain in this. Because, oh, I just never would have thought that, like... Because I was sitting here, I remember, like, thinking about it and stuff while I'm watching this movie. I was like, damn, like, he was only in a couple of scenes. And then after that, you know, gone. So, I'm thinking it had to be someone else who also knew Shiki and Ish. And I was like, okay, like, yeah, maybe it's male Shiki, but male Shiki dead. Ew. But damn, like, the fact that he was obsessed with her... That's crazy. I mean, almost in a way, he, like, idolized her. And it really seemed like that a lot. And, I mean, woo, Jesus. I can't believe I'm about to say this, because he really gave me feels to this character that I like so much. He really definitely gave me a lot of Cutthroat vibes from Akudama Drive. Only, like, in, like, some ways, because Cutthroat is... he is a murderer, if you have not seen Akudama Drive. And the connection of Cutthroat and Swindler and the shit that happens in Akudama Drive, I don't want to spoil it for people who have not seen it, but if you have not, go watch it. It's only like freaking 12 episodes. You can get it done in a day. But the murders that Cutthroat does, like, because we barely really still even today know that much about Cutthroat. And watching this, and especially with how Leo did his kills and how he started,
it gave me the feels of that. And it's like, okay, maybe Cutthroat could have did something like that. But, I mean, Leo, you sick, twisted motherfucker. What the fuck? I mean, oh my god. This just said in a nutshell is like, don't do drugs and don't kill people. Because, you know, shit, the things that you will do. Like, say no to drugs. Like, but, oh. This was really good. Oh my god. Like, oh, I can't. This is crazy, but it was really interesting. I think, yeah, as much as I loved part one, I think I like this one a lot better. I do like the callbacks to part one because, of course, you need it in especially a two-parter movie, because if you don't have callbacks for it to connect and everything and to answer certain questions, then yeah. But, oh, God, yeah, even male Shiki killing himself in order for Shiki to be normal again, that was crazy. Like, I wasn't expecting that to go that way. I'm thinking that, you know, we were ending it in that maybe, like, male Shiki or our Shiki would have just stabbed herself and stuff in order to kill male Shiki. But male Shiki was like, fuck it, I'm gonna get hit by Carcoon. And that's it. Like, bam. But the moment when Leo came through the knife and was basically like, yeah, I killed Miki, the one other person who you care about in this world, I really thought Shiki was going to kill herself. Because of the relationship of Miki and Shiki, and because even though Shiki has not really acknowledged the fact that she does love him, the sexual tension, one, the connection, two, the chemistry, three, and the way that they both truly feel about each other, they'll literally do anything for each other. So I was just like, is she really about to kill herself? And Miki's gonna come right as she's like, her body is just slowly going from warmth to just cold as ice. And it would have been, I would have cried if that happened. Like, hell, you got me to cry. Like, goddamn it, I didn't want to cry. I teared up. I didn't want that. Like, Jesus Christ. After the day, and especially when y'all see this on Friday, the week or the day I had on fucking Monday, Jesus Christ, like, a lot of things has happened today. Like, I can't. This is way too much today. But honestly, I am glad that I was able to have the time to watch it today, because I think, really, this is the only really time that I had to be able to watch this. But yeah, I mean, she fucking gutted this boy like it was nobody's business. Like, oh my god. She just was like, okay, yeah, I took your arm. I'm taking your other arm. I'm taking your legs. And then I'm just going to stab you in the back. And then that's it. You're dead. Like, don't come back. You are just dead, dead. But, like, holy crap. It's just crazy how someone, the things that someone will do when they become so obsessed or idolize someone, how far someone could be willing to go. But, like, oh god. But damn, I mean, honestly, this, ooh, possibly has to be my new favorite now. I mean, dead ass, until I see how, you know, the rest of this series plays out for the rest of these movies. And if we possibly, I mean, because, well, every single week, we kind of get a good good opening, good ending. That's the word, Deja. The fact that she's there waiting for him, like, oh! You got an eye patch now?
that's your real fate. I mean, fuck. Yeah. Oh. Well, because who else is going to do it? This just feels like them. Like, we don't need any other movies, but no, of course, there are other movies. That was sweet. Oh my god. I think this is currently now what the happiest ending. Even though, yeah, like, Nikki, damn, you lost your eye. Damn. Like, damn. I mean, ooh, and no preview to next week. Oh. Really? Wow. No preview to the next movie? Oh. That's interesting. Okay. I mean, like, I understand maybe why. But, I mean, because, like, yeah, honestly, the way this movie ends, it's, like, necessarily saying, okay, this is the finale, and that you necessarily don't really need to watch the next movies, even though I am going to watch the next movies, but it's, like, okay, now, especially looking at however many movies I have left, so that could be from movie 8 to whatever the last movie is in the series, what else could necessarily happen next? But it just seems like, you know, now these two are they're together now, and they're going to be spending the rest of their lives together. Oh my god, this is sweet. Like, it just felt like a nice, neat little bow on all of them, even though we ain't even done. We just beginning with this shit. Like, oh my god. But, like, that was sweet, honestly. I hate the fact that, yeah, Miki lost his eye. I mean, because, oh god, I was expecting him to possibly lose, like, an arm or maybe a hand. Not his eye, but, like, whoo, fuck. Just, ooh, big ol' fuck right now. Mm-hmm, yes. But this one was really good. Really, really good. And it makes me honestly, like, how are the next ones going to hold against this film? And such. Out of the first 7 movies, this now is my new favorite, really. For what I truly needed out of part 2, after watching part 1, and then how everything orchestrated from beginning to end. The ending with them walking away, being happy at the moment, up until whatever the hell is about to happen in the next movie. Because, who knows? Y'all fucking know. That's it. I know. But, yeah, I really enjoyed it this far. I mean, like, damn. It just makes me scared about whatever the fuck is about to happen. I mean, you know, what else can this series do? I mean,
Really, like, dead ass. But I also think Leo was a very interesting character up until his death. Honestly, like, dead ass. Like, something just really tells me that possibly, knowing Kadaka probably maybe to get his, like, a little bit of, like, insight of, like, Cutthroat. Maybe he watched this and maybe he got inspired from that or something. But between the fact that Kadaka also got, fall in love with, like, his love for, like, what are the type of movies that, oh my god, Quentin Tarantino movies and things like that. But yeah, I mean, deadass, like, Leo reminds me 100% of Cutthroat, but then there's some things that, like, they're similar, but they're different at the same time. But yeah, he was interesting up until, like, the point he got yeeted, because he got yeeted really, really bad. But damn, like, still, this was a really good fucking movie. I enjoyed it a lot. I might even have to watch it again, because damn, this was just too fucking good. But other than that, guys, that is my reaction view towards episode or movie 7 of The Garden of Sinners. If you guys enjoyed it, please give me a like. It really helps me out. Also, subscribe to my channel. I make videos every single day. Join the Master Squad. And of course, I will see you guys officially, y'all, next time for movie 8. Or unless movie 8 is a recap, I'm gonna check before I watch movie 8. But if not, I will see you guys all next time for movie 9. Bye. And I froze again. I sure did.